How's it going, guys? Another update on my self-cast. I have Winter Elementalist, currently level 93. I mentioned yesterday that I had enough heists that I could probably level to level 93, so I ran all of my heists in one blueprint, and sure enough, level 93. So today, I'm going to go over upgrades, I'm going to run this invitation, and then I'm going to kill Drox, and I'm going to kill Veritania. And that's what we're going to do. So, first thing I upgraded yesterday was I put on this helmet that I was talking about. That freed some stuff up. Putting on this evasion got me really thinking. It's like, okay, let's build some more evasion and make myself a little bit more survivable. So I put in inspiration in place of hypothermia. So now I have Eye of Winter, increased critical strikes, increased critical damage, inspiration, cold pin, added cold damage, and these are about to hit level 20 again, so I'm gonna get another boost in damage. So I swapped, putting in inspiration lowers my mana cost of skills, so that allowed me to replace my mana flask with a jade flask, and that solved my mana issues that I was having. So the jade flask is also, I can push the right buttons here, with the jade flask up, 38% chance to evade. That's up from zero. My only evasion was my gloves and boots. But maybe it was I don't remember, but much better chance to evade, and I've been dying way less. I had this belt on yesterday. I found this from a ritual. I forgot to show this off, but I put this on because I had the strength, and I need the strength to level up gems, which are still capped out, but not the biggest deal there. So let's throw in this invitation and kill some bosses. Most of these I've done have been pretty bad or gone pretty poorly. Oh, and I guess I should mention, I decided, okay, I'm going to alt spam a jewel until I hit something good. And then I regaled this jewel, and so I've got 26% damage plus 12 crit multi on this jewel. That damage increase, 28,137 to 29,864. So that was a big upgrade, but I got another jewel. This came from my heists and has fractured T1 cold damage to spells. So I spent 40 chaos on this until I hit another decent cold damage to spells. This one also, right around, it's almost the exact same amount of DPS as this one. So I put this one in, 28,139, this one in, 28,137. So this jewel is giving me about the same damage as this one. So this is probably better than me trying to get another one. But things are getting a lot better. Actually have boss damage, and this is only monster level 80, I believe. So this isn't the hardest this could be. Oh, well, that's physical damage. Where is he? All right, he's got to go. All right. I guess all three went down at the same time. Okay. What else do we have in here? Okay, we've got the curse. Okay, that... The golem is fine. The other two can do physical damage, so I'm going to focus on them. That ice golem can do whatever it wants. It's not going to hurt me. Literally, only die to physical damage on this build. That's how it goes. He's cake. Bitter dream. Alright, what do I want here? Yeah, this is going to go beyond. Yep, and then I'm gonna get Torn Veil, and then this is gonna be where I'm using for like super juicing levels, but that's also gonna be fizz damage, so we'll see how that goes. I think it's gonna be a really fun like headhunter zone. If I ever can get a headhunter. Okay. Go next. Do Beartania first. Bidden Woods, T14. That's fine. My map clear has just, like, even in rolled T16s, which I haven't done much of, like, damage is just popping off. Well, I was really excited to find that Hypnotic Jewel, because that's increasing my flat damage. It's not relying on the crit. Like everything's based off of that. But the harder you hit stuff, right, the better chance you have it freezing, and, like, I'm just tearing stuff apart. Increased projectile speed would be cool on this as well, which I think is a helm enchant that I could get. That's gonna increase the clear, like the range that I can clear. So I think I'd rather have the projectile speed than increased damage on the helm enchant. But I haven't run labs for that yet. I wanted to get up to running higher tier stuff before I worried about running helm enchants, because I want other helms so I can store other useful enchants that aren't for this. Piercing Truth, not doing that one. I'm gonna skip the Gwinnin too, because I care. And I don't need to worry about my bone chill or exposure in there. I think because this is Beartania, these bosses get extra cold res, but these bosses might do physical damage too. I haven't really figured it out. Although I guess this is a really good build to like see what damage you're taking. Because if you're taking just pure elemental damage, it comes from up here. Taking fizz plus elemental damage, it comes down from the Aegis and from your ES. If you're taking chaos damage, it comes from the life and not the ES. So it's really easy to see like what the damage is. It's really cool. I just got hit by something from this guy over here, and it looked like it did physical and elemental damage. I like them to be all bunched up so I can get them all at once. I don't understand these bosses because I haven't really toyed with them enough. So I'm being a little extra cautious. The only things seem to get different once you kill some of them. One of them just like charges up like ice spears or something along those lines. Probably a lot of mechanics to this boss fight. Oh, and they're being healed by Maven. And I get a little Hydrosphere thing. Okay. Beartania. Hopefully this goes a lot better than my Baron did the other day. Oh yeah. My damage is actually seeming decent. It's not super terrible. That's all elemental damage. The golems can body block, but it's risky to let them and just attack during that phase.
I shall free you.
Yep, then they just get through on me. Almost.
I shall free you.
All right, Veritania. Easy peasy. Now, for Drox. Drox is a little bit more scary because he does physical damage and lots of it. So, see how that one goes. Alphamation, cool, easy map. Still gaining experience. It's awesome. I'd love to keep getting levels. And the build's getting to the point where it's like, okay, I might actually be able to take on these bosses. It's feeling good enough that I can do that. Maze map. She didn't drop me in Awakened Cold, though. I probably should have really remembered to put my extra Watchstone back in. I'm currently, I think, at Awakener level 7 because I'm missing one Watchstone to farm, target farm those maps and Haywork. Pop this. And this is a white map, so it's not the biggest show of like limits on things. Because you get increased life and 40% elemental resistances. Things get a little bit tougher to kill, but still, like, I'm one-shotting the banners that are getting dropped. Still have yet to pick up one of these items off of the ground that's actually worth anything. The Tainted Chaos Orb is cool though. In case you do find something, this one doesn't want to die. In case you do find something that has good corruptions on it, then you could try and re-roll it, but I don't know. Still questioning why I even see them on the filter. The last Drox I did, which wasn't a T15 map, it was so much harder than this. If I got anywhere close to anything, I was just like getting one shot because of the fizz damage. That might have been before I had the 6-link. I don't quite recall. Things are just so much smoother now. Build feels amazing. And like, if you have enough damage, going into Nightmare doesn't really matter too much. And it can still only get better. I don't have Awaken Gems. My wands are pretty garbage. Like, both of my wands, I don't see myself being able to sell them for more than 10 chaos on trade. I could be wrong, but there's still a lot to be desired out of both of them. Alright, made it to the boss. Now we'll pop in here one more time, why not? Collect physical damage. I don't know if it's even possible to scale reflect in this game to any kind of meaningful value. Oh, we can fire over this, can we? Alright. What do we got? What are we upgrading? Map. Okay. Oh, come on. Okay. Thought it was gonna get by me there. Okay. Now I gotta play this one perfectly. There's a lot that can one-shot me in here. This is so much better than the last Drox fight I did. Ooh. I evaded this banner. Though single banner could have possibly one-shot me. I don't know. I can try and keep up endurance charges. That'll help a bit. Those fists? But it's stuff like this is why I have the spell cascade on the frost bomb. Okay. Alright, we're in the mid phase. Destroy these banners so they're not all spawning at the center during the final phase. If I had enough damage, I would just nuke him, but not quite to that point yet. The Chaos Golem terrifies me that I have. I always see its like attack going along the ground, and I've been one-shot by that so many times from actual Chaos Golems in maps and such. Yeah, that's a scary one. Still, like, I've been playing this build for a few days now, and yeah, seeing that Sunder-like attack really sketches me out. So I pay a lot of attention to the shock value. I can't point it out with the mouse. Or not the shock, the chill value that shows up under the boss's HP. That's how I know if it's bone chilled or not. So I can tell like when I need to reapply bone chill. Is it 20? It gets to 21 with the cold snap at like 23 or something with the cross blink. There we go. There is that. So, couple other things to look at. It didn't run a lot of Scourge today, so there's nothing too much to show in there. But I got another 6 link, and this was not from the div cards that I was farming yesterday. I got an incubator, a Geomancer's incubator. So only level 78, but it is a decent base. Armor evasion 6 link. There's a lot that can be done with this. Now, I also got a 30% quality lightning coil, which I did 6 socket and 5 link. I would like to try and 6 link this and potentially try and use this on this character. If I can put this character is stupid tanky, just without a doubt, but it needs a divine. Like I don't want to corrupt it and without giving this a chance to be better rolled on the armor evasion. I don't care as much about the life. I care more about the armor evasion. Then I also got a Queen of the Forest, which I also 5 linked, which I'm going to play with in a second. Oh, I got a Deadly Joy, which I'd never seen this divination card. They're fairly expensive in trade, but this gives you a 2 implicit Corrupted Torrents Reclamation. It's probably only one of these cards I'll see all the league. But yeah, I also never had a Torrents Reclamation. It's the belt that is upgraded, I think, from buff. Okay. So in my process of trying to make a jewel, I made this jewel. So I've got a 32% lightning multi jewel with resistances. Could be exalted, but I'm not going to do that right now. I got a level 21 flesh offering. Because when I was running on my heist, I forgot to switch out the trinket. But I also really, really like the chance to receive additional gems when opening reward chests. From heist, it's really nice. So I wasn't getting the beefy uniques, but I got a bunch of 20 quality gems, including this 21 flesh offering, which was awesome. I got a storm rain damage on an evasion base helm enchant. Storm rain is something I definitely want to try out this league at some point. So having this helm enchant's really awesome. Only level 78 on the helmet, but that's kind of goes to show why I haven't just like ran helm enchants yet, because this is an 85 helmet. I want good bases. So, my blueprint that I ran got me anomalous meat shield, which minions from supported skills deal up to 5% more damage to enemies that are near you. That's more damage on meat shield. So I had to go with that. Anomalous additional accuracy gives crit multi. There wasn't anything better than this, but it's also pretty awesome. Like, if you really need accuracy or you're playing some kind of accuracy stacking thing, I feel like this could be really good. Summon raging spirits with increased minion duration. I can't see anything. I don't know what their initial effect was there. So I grabbed that. And then there's the Anomalous Brand Recall. Anomalous Brand Recall gives up to 20% increased brand cooldown recovery rate, which is amazing. And let me pull up PoEDB here to show. There was another one that I wanted. I don't remember what it was. It's been a while. But if I do Brand Recall, like I checked them, and no, it was Storm Rain, with increased like beam frequency, so they would attack with a faster rate. I really wanted that, but Anomalous Grand Recall has a weighting of 20, so it's really rare. So I had to grab that. And let's just see, what's an Anomalous Grand Recall worth in trade? Nothing. But SSF, like, that's a lot of cooldown recovery rate for a brand build. Alright, so, like I said, I want to wait on this one, but I'm going to take this Queen of the Forest now. We're going to go up here, we're going to corrupt it, reduce chaos damage taken. So now, I'm going to play with a Tainted Fusing Orb. So, this says it unpredictably adds or removes a link to the largest group of linked sockets on a corrupted item. So this should be a 50-50 chance to six link this. And there we go. Boom. Six link Queen of the Forest. That right there explains why my six link Carcass Jack in the actual league was so cheap, because we can do things like this. And yeah, that's lovely. I don't know that I want to use this on this build. But definitely nice to have for sure. Not the best rolled either, but hey, actually use the Tainted Fusing. So that's going to be it for me for today. I hope y'all enjoyed. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you tomorrow with Cirrus. Finally, it's going to happen. Cheers.